In the previous video, we learned that primary frequency control is activated right after a disturbance to suppress the frequency deviations for about several seconds. In this video, we address the secondary and tertiary frequency control that will be activated in a longer time periods from 1 minute up to several hours. We address three main learning objectives. Firstly, what is the secondary frequency control and when it is activated? Secondly, how the secondary control is implemented in a two-area network. Thirdly, what is the tertiary control? In the previous videos, we've emphasized that the frequency shall be always maintained at the rated value. If there is a mismatch between the generation and the demand, for instance, due to the outage of one generating unit, then the frequency starts to decrease. If no control is applied, then the frequency largely deviates and reaches a very low steady state value due to which the electrical grid is shut down. If the primary frequency control is implemented, then the large frequency deviations right after the disturbance can be effectively suppressed. However, as it can be seen, the frequency does not go back to the rated value using the primary frequency control and remains at a steady state, a value below the nominal one. As the system shall operate always at the nominal frequency, this steady state error shall be eliminated. To this end, the secondary frequency control, or the so-called low frequency control, is implemented that is activated after the primary control. It is an automatic control that restores the frequency back to its reference value in a centralized way from 1 minute up to several minutes. In the slide, we see that the generic frequency control scheme of single area power system, where the mismatch between the generation and the demand is reflected as the frequency deviation delta F. To implement the primary control, we mentioned that the inverse of the droop control, RGI, is multiplied. Now we show how the secondary control can be implemented in one generating unit to remove the steady state error of the frequency. To do so, it is required to apply an integral controller with the coefficient Ki. In a two-area power system, the secondary control adjusts the active power, which is shared between the interconnected areas according to their scheduled power set points. As shown in the figure, two areas, which are connected through a transmission line, are operated at the nominal frequency. If a contingency event occurs in one of these areas, then the frequencies of these two areas start to deviate. However, during the event, the frequency of the first area is not equal to the frequency of the second one. We present the frequency control schemes of two areas which are connected to each other through a transmission line. Within each area, we refer to the area control error, or ACE, as the excess or the deficiency of a certain amount of active power. This error is not only eliminated by the generating units within the area, but also partly covered by the other areas through the tie line. The amount of the power which is being exchanged between two areas during the disturbance is obtained according to the frequency deviations in these two areas. Finally, the frequency of each area is adjusted to the nominal value through the secondary controllers. For each area, a bias constant is considered. The typical choice of these bias constants is the sum of the load variation and the primary regulation. So far, we discussed that the secondary control helps maintain the level of the frequency at the nominal values after the disturbance, as it is shown in the green curve. To achieve this, however, the power set points of the generating units need to be adjusted during the disturbance, as it is shown in the blue curve. Therefore, there will be a steady state deviations for the power of the generating units before and after the disturbance. The tertiary control is added to the previous control scheme, where it manually adjusts the persistent deviation of the power from several minutes to several hours after disturbance. In multi-area electrical grids, for instance from area 1 to area N, the area control error shall be properly distributed among all the generators, and this is why the tertiary control is needed. This is typically carried out through a factor, the so-called departicipation factor, PF. Note that these participant factors for the areas 1 to N are determined according to the outcomes of the economic dispatch. In this video, we address the role of the secondary control in a power system and how it is implemented in a two-area network by the bias factors. This control plays a vital role in recovering the frequency to the nominal values after a disturbance. We also discussed that the tertiary control is executed to mitigate and adjust the steady-state deviation of power using the participation factors.